Fixing the remote validation problem. In our last lecture, we saw that when we were updating the profile of a user, then remote validation was coming in our way. It was telling us that the email ID already exists because the same data entry form was being used for editing that was being used for data entry, the same form. So now we have to fix the problem so that it doesn't occur when we are editing a record. Let us discuss the plan. There are four players in the game. One is the editing form which hosts your editor template. This template fits into this one. And then these annotations, they bind to the controls on this form, and this is a remote validator. There are four players. So what we have to do is we have to put a flag here which tells it to turn off or suppress the validation. One flag will be required here. This is one of the solutions. Maybe better could be there, but this is one I have always found handy. One flag will be required here. This is one. The second thing is, so I'll put this as the first. The second thing is that we have to tell the annotation to honor this flag. This is the second thing we have to do. So we have to make some modification to the annotation also, the remote annotation. Thirdly, this editor template has to know whether it is being used for editing or data entry. This means this form that is being used for editing, this will pass some information to the template, and template will accordingly put a field here, modify its structure, so that when that field is passed, when that field exists, this flag starts working. Because is email available will be called from editor template. Editor template will contain an information. The hosting form will contain some flag which will be read by the editor template. And editor template will in turn make some alteration to the form and pass a flag to the is email available, which will then work in combination with TBL user N to prevent the annotation from firing. So these four players have to work in combination. In thumb rule nutshell, we have to basically make a mechanism here so that this annotation doesn't fire when the editor template is being used for data editing. Translating this into the C# code, let us now put this scheme to work. Here it is. First of all, this is your is email available. This is your remote annotation. Let us put a flag here. We are bringing HF suppress remote a flag, and this flag will be causing a modification here. If HF remote is 1, then the validation will be turned off. So this is the one change that you need here. The second change you will do is in the hosting form called edit customer. This is the current form which is hosting your customer form. We'll put here in the view bag, suppress remote validation is yes. This will now pass to the customer form, and here is the customer form. Customer form will read the existence. If view bag dot suppress remote validation is there, then it puts a hidden field hf suppress remote with a value of 1. This means this 1 will now be a value, a hidden field that is additionally put in the customer form. Now how will this hf suppress remote move to is email available, because it is required here. For this we have to come to our annotation, and here we have a possibility of putting additional fields is equal to hf suppress remote. This means when remote validation is occurring, this customer form will send hf suppress remote as an additional field to is email available, and then the logic is there for checking whether it is to be enabled or disabled. So with these four changes in place, let us run and see. Click to login, search AB, search edit, and now let us make a change to this one. And now you can see that this one is not firing. Click on save and it works. We can verify whether the create customer has not been disturbed. Let us add the rate. And click on save. Record saved. And let us try to enter some existing record. And in that case, user already exists, so create customer is working fine. So this is how we have actually now completed our form for editing the customer. Now this one works absolutely fine. So we'll close it right now. Thanks.